The message tonight is to get a quick start to return to the win column.
We've got to take some shots. We've got to take some shots.
Hey, Callie, how'd it come? Shot by Callahan, he scores!
But after the team plays the first period as instructed, a defensive lapse by Ryan McDonagh in the second proves costly.
McDonagh gave it away to Malone. He's in, he scores!
Just 2 minutes later, though, a Lightning power play returns the momentum unexpectedly back towards the Rangers.
Delzato to Anisimov! He scores! A shorthanded goal!
Even as Tampa Bay takes exception to Artem Anisimov's exuberance.
And we've got some after-the-goal stuff going on here.
Enough! You understand? Enough, man. Good work. Good job.
Hey, he started the whole fucking thing. How's he not getting a goddamn fucking penalty? Look, Javier.
2 and 10.
Like for what?
Like what I do?
2 and 10 is 2 minutes for whatever attempted misconduct. No, for what?
No, just.
You guys talk about it.
Just explain. Just explain to me, fuck me.
I don't have to explain.
Oh, you might
be. That all started, John, because of all that bullshit with Anisimov. So he's going to get the two front sports from, like, the canceling it all out.
Everything else is canceling out.
Yeah.
Have you seen, listen, I don't agree with it, but have you seen that in the league and been called a penalty?
Not that much. I haven't seen that much and not been called. To stay from the net all the way to the blue line doing that is not kosher. So I'm giving an extra.
Anisimov receives 16 penalty minutes in total following his goal, which means he'll spend the rest of the period in the locker room waiting for his team to join him at intermission.
You sure have a goal?
Sorry. No, just... reload my weapon, you know?
Yeah, reload that shit.
These are the kinds of strange turns in hockey games that have long ceased to surprise John Tortorella. Everything he offers to his team in response is calculated accordingly.
All right, now we have our work cut out for us here with our own stupidity. All right, so let's make sure we are sharp through that neutral zone, and even prior to the mess that happened out there, we're not physical enough offensively in the offensive zone. Keep your fucking discipline here now. There's no yapping. There's no yapping to the referees. There's no yapping at them. You got a half hour of work. If you do it right, we'll win a hockey game. But no, they're coming. They're going to come. Let's make sure we defend first and get in their end zone. All right, let's be ready to go again.
Two minutes to go in the third. Moore moves to the net. Backhand, he scores! A shorthanded goal!
We're going to have some bumps. That's where you gotta stay with your conviction, because you start changing things around because there's some struggles, then everybody's second guessing. It's a matter of not losing your patience, and there may be some kicking and scratching going along, but you're still within your concept to try to get back to where you wanna be.
Nights like this one can remind a young team like the Rangers how fragile a lead can be, and how many ways a hockey game can be given away.
It's up to Marion Gaborik. He must score to keep it alive for the Rangers. Gaborik fakes, saved by Garon, and it's over.
I think the way you bond is you go through circumstances together, some winning, some losing. Some situations in the room.
Guys, sorry by me. I didn't mean to like do something bad tonight, like when my celebration. Sorry.
The penalty did not result in a score. Technically, it had nothing to do with the loss. But the apology is an acknowledgement of what might have been, and how much hockey remains to be played together.